The simple things are the ones most needed today if we are to surmount what divides us and cement what unites us.
The audacity of hope. In the end, that is God's greatest gift to us, the bedrock of this nation.
America has suffered from a fever of words.
One part of the course is you have terms like liberal, conservative, Democrat, and Republican. And oftentimes we have these thought bubbles that operate in our head when we hear those terms. But the history and how it is that we associate those terms with each other is a really complicated history of the last 40 years. So a huge part of our course is going back to 45 years ago, where you had conservative Democrats, liberal Republicans. There wasn't the same kind of ideological consistency that we typically associate now with either of the two major political parties.
Actually, our first class, we kind of talked about the political landscape right now and terms like Democrat, Republican, liberal, and conservative. And we kind of deconstructed the history of how those terms, Republican and conservative and Democrat and liberal, came to be synonymous. And we have worked backwards and we have looked at each election basically from 1964 until 2012.
I think that's another huge challenge that the students are really excited for, is just better understanding these terms that we use and that we throw around so easily. There's a really rich and complicated history that comes with understanding.
And Mr. Hession also really emphasizes the importance of analysis. So these days he's really challenging us to really take what we learned through the media that we looked at and apply it to the history that we're learning about. But I also really like how Mr. Hession incorporates present day politics into our classes as well. And like continuously encourages us to draw parallels between what we're learning about in past elections and today's elections. And obviously there are so many parallels just because the state of polarization has only increased and a lot of the tensions between the two parties are still existent today.
In terms of historical inquiry, looking at a diverse set of topics and really understanding how it is that there develops this ideological consistency within each party, it's a fascinating historical course of inquiry to just explore through the 70s, 80s, and 90s, and to better understand how the world that our students are coming of political age in, you really, party identification is one of the most predictive measures of, and we take it for granted, but it's one of the most predictive measures of how a person's gonna cast a ballot.
It's been challenging to read stuff like, so we have this book by Dan Carter about the rise in conservatism. And in that book, he talks a lot about the campaigning tactics of people like George Wallace and Nixon and Ronald Reagan. And at what point he writes that like good campaigning does not make, no longer equates good governance. And that's just really jarring to me. Like, I feel like politics has become such a game at this point and like a play on power instead of actually like trying to help like the American people.
I think one of the great things about the course is I am, when we're talking about an issue like that, I'm kind of learning alongside them and kind of wondering the same thing.
This class has definitely been really grounding during this time because I can count on it as a place where we can have really intellectual conversations about history rather than our own beliefs.
America has suffered from a fever of words, from inflated rhetoric that promises more than it can deliver, from angry rhetoric that fans discontents into hatreds, from bombastic rhetoric that postures instead of persuading. We cannot learn from one another until we stop shouting at one another.
Now, even as we speak, there are those who are preparing to divide us. The spin masters, the negative ad peddlers, who embrace the politics of anything goes. Well, I say to them tonight, there is not a liberal America and a conservative America. There is the United States of America.